Now back to the Rams on WMIX.
And welcome back to CHS Arena on MyWithersRadio.com, on your radio on 94.1 FM WMIX. Chris Hugo with Danny Derwinski alongside. Tonight, Danny, the mound for the Rams with that 4-1 record on the line against the 1-4 Centralia Orphans, who come in struggling somewhat after only getting the one win at the Jacksonville Crimson Classic last week. Rams, meanwhile, winners of the Pyramid Plus tournament, come in here looking to make this a chess match tonight between Scott Gamber and Lee Bennett.
I think the 1-4 record for Centralia is a tad bit deceiving, because in several of those losses that Centralia had last weekend at Jacksonville, they were in those ball games and deep into the fourth quarter, and unfortunately for the Orphans, they didn't pull through. They battled some injuries. They battled some younger players in the lineup compared to last year's lineup that went to state. So Lee Bennett's Orphans are trying to learn as they go. And again, with the number of games they played last week, five, Lee Bennett said in the papers this week he was looking forward to a week of practice. So I'm guessing the Orphans are going to be ready to go for the Rams here this evening.
Well, and we can only assume so. They come in with that 1-4 mark. Neither team played a conference game just yet. That all changes here tonight at the CHS Arena. Chris Hugo with Danny Derwinski. Again, no video tonight on MyWithersRadio.com. Just audio for you. And, of course, 50,000 watts of Rams basketball. Rim Lake College offers over 100 degree and certificate programs for thousands less. Visit your virtual counselor at rlc.edu. We'll have plenty of scoreboard updates coming your way tonight. A big one coming here shortly, as we have some finals already pouring in from some shootouts and other tournament action around the area, and some quarterly updates as well. Let's go ahead and take a look at an early scoreboard.
Update, halftime of the DuCoin tournament, Benton leads Carroll 37-30. A final from the Oakville tournament tonight, Marissa Coulterville beat New Athens 44-35. A girls' score from the Marshall County, Kentucky shootout, Marshall County, Kentucky beat Mount Carmel 67-64. And the JV score here tonight, a final, Mount Vernon opens up their season with a win, beating Centralia 33-27.
And, of course, that scoreboard update brought to you by Tony Wilton, State Farm Insurance. For all of your insurance financial service needs, visit your local State Farm agent, Tony Wilt. He's on the corner of 42nd South Water Tower in Mount Vernon, or online at TonyWilt.com. Walk in, call in, or click in like a good neighbor. State Farm is there. We'll step out for a break. When we come back, we'll dissect this matchup between the Mount Vernon Rams and the Centralia Orphans. Live from the CHS Arena, this is Rams Basketball on WMIX.
More Americans are on the move today than ever before. One of the most popular modes of transportation is the motorcycle. Motorcycles take us to our jobs, school, to the beach, and all around the country. If you're a bike rider, your Pekin Insurance Agency, Page Insurance on Crownview and Mount Vernon, wants to make sure you have the best insurance protection while you're riding. Ask about the money-saving auto cycle discount and the experienced driver discount, too. Call Page Insurance at 242-7000 today about motorcycle insurance from Pekin Insurance.
It's amazing how versatile the Saturday sports show has become. What do you mean you slept in last week? Set your alarm for 8:08 this Saturday morning and tune your radio to AM 940. More Mount Vernon Rams talk, more Jefferson County talk, and more amped up coverage of Southern Illinois sports. Hear from the best coaches, experts, and sports know-it-alls available. Sports talk worth waking up for. Saturday mornings from 8:08 till 10 a.m. on WMIX AM 940 and online at MyWithersRadio.com. Presented by Crossroads Community Hospital.
On November 5th, Community First Bank and the First State Bank of Dix officially partnered to better serve our customers and our community. Hi, I'm Joe David Cummins, president of Community First Bank. We welcome all our new friends to the Community First family. And I'd like to personally invite you to call, log in, or drop by any of our five locations to learn more about Jefferson County's only true, locally owned community bank.
Community First Bank, with locations in Mount Vernon, Woodlawn, Dix, and Ina. Welcome back to Personal Banking. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
When it comes to bone and joint care, only one name should come to mind. The Orthopedic Center of Southern Illinois. Your fellowship-trained physician's first priority is specialized orthopedic care, ranging from total joint replacement and spine surgery to shoulder surgery and sports medicine. Our surgeons provide a wide range of specialized treatments that are unparalleled anywhere in Southern Illinois. Located on Veterans Memorial Drive in Mount Vernon and St. Mary's Good Samaritan's in Campus, the Orthopedic Center of Southern Illinois. Discover the difference.
This is Mike Reese. You're listening to the Rams on WMIX.
And welcome back to the CHS Arena, WMIX online at MyWithersRadio.com for your Rim Lake College pregame show. At Rim Lake College, you get a quality education and save thousands. Visit your virtual counselor at rlc.edu. Rim Lake College It's time. Danny Zawinski alongside. I'm Chris Hugo here with you as they celebrate the 2011 second place finish in Class 3A due to the Centralia Orphans. And Danny, I know some people are wondering, well, why do it when Mount Vernon's coming in? They wanted to do it first home game, decided it well before the schedule came out. And I suppose a fitting tribute to a team that went so far in the postseason.
Well, it's no disrespect. It's just one of those deals when a lot of high school teams, obviously you don't have a warm-up night or whatever. Some may have a shoot-around or whatever, but it's important to have the crowd here as you return and as many players as could return tonight for Centralia can come back. And it's a cool thing that they're going to do. They're going to introduce the players and the coaches from the team from last year, and then they will walk over and they will actually, as a group, hoist the banner up into the rafters here at the gymnasium. So a very cool idea, a very cool concept, and a very big crowd on hand. They're showing their appreciation from Centralia.
Well, and of course, Scott Gamber's team in the locker room right now preparing for this contest during this celebration as they will hoist that second place banner. And that can be a good thing or a bad thing, Danny, when you have to go back in the locker room during a lengthy celebration. One, I guess you could make the point that you have more time to maybe prepare, go over some extra things. The other thing is you come out here and warm up, have to go back into the locker room, and will that take any edge off of the momentum you may have while warming up?
Well, the one thing they've done tonight is they let the teams come out and warm up first, then they send them back to the locker room, and they will sit there for a while, and then they have 6 minutes up on the clock, so the teams will have some time to actually get reacquainted and get warmed up again. The thing about it is that in this kind of game, with the rivalry and everything, it shouldn't take much to get the teams focused on what they need to do tonight in this basketball game. If you're Mount Vernon, you're back there. And again, as we've talked about, when you go on the road, you not only have to play well, but you have to play better than the home team. And Mount Vernon's going to get that tonight, because there'll be some momentum off of this team being back here tonight and all this momentum going on that Mount Vernon's going to have to battle that emotion and the excitement that the current version of the Centralia Orphans will bring to the floor.
Well, and I mean, it was a big season, obviously, for Centralia one season ago. The Rams fell just short in a regional championship or a regional semifinal on this floor, falling to Modern Day 44-43. Centralia, of course, goes on to defeat Modern Day in the regional championship, take care of Salem and, I believe, Jerseyville, or maybe Highland in the sectional. Then they had Morton up there at the super, and then the rest is history, of course, up there at the state finals. Now, for the Rams, meanwhile, have a lot of returning stars, or at least stars in the making, including a newcomer, Leontay Badger. He and Tyrell Trimble, a senior, both made the alternate team at the Pyramid Plus tournament.
And great weeks for those seniors, except, you know, especially Badger had a great week. Trimble did a great job scoring early in the tournament. I think did an even better job handling the basketball and running the team last week at Heron. That's the same qualities this team will need the rest of the year, as they will look to Trimble to be the senior leader on the floor with the basketball. And you have to enjoy and like what you saw at Scott Gamber's Rams next week. If, after a week off of practice, you try to work on the things that were exposed last week, you try to make things better that you can do well, and you go from there, and you try to bring it into this weekend. Now, this is a tough weekend, building up for a whole week to get ready for this game, and then to turn around in less than 24 hours to tip off on the road at Effingham St. Anthony. This is a character-building weekend. You go on the road in the conference game tonight, you return in less than 24 hours, and you go back and play a game on the road at Effingham St. Anthony.
Well, Danny, the thing I take away from this weekend here on the Rim Lake College pregame show, Rim Lake College offers over 100 degree and certificate program for 1,000 class. Visit your virtual counselor at rlc.edu. But the thing I take away from this weekend, if you're not just going to any two places, you're going to two places where they count the number of victories on their wall. Centralia well over 2,000. St. Anthony not quite there, over, I believe, 1,200. However, you're going two places where basketball is a proud tradition, tough places to play, both newer modern facilities, and that can be kind of tough on a team in well less than 24 hours.
Well, travel is going to be a thing. It won't be much of an issue tonight. The key will be, you know, the bus to Effingham tomorrow. It's not really a bad trip, but again, it's a quick turnaround. You're going to play tonight. You're going to get home at a, you know, late hour for a Friday night. Then you're going to have to get up and be ready to go and back on a bus probably by 11 o'clock tomorrow or earlier. And you're going to have a focus to get things going tomorrow, because tomorrow is the proverbial trap game, which sets after Centralia and before the home opener against Altoff. The team has to be ready to go.
Well, ready to go indeed. And we'll see if the Rams are ready here tonight. Mount Vernon Centralia is coming up your way in just a little bit. We'll stay here for now on your Rim Lake College pregame show and talk about some other games of interest in the area. Tonight, the Woodlawn Cardinals play for a championship
at the Oakville post-Thanksgiving tournament against the Oakville Rockets. Both teams come in undefeated tonight. And, Danny, that is going to be a great basketball game between two teams expected to make a pretty deep run in Class 1A.
Well, it is. And the thing about that matchup is Woodlawn and Oakville have kind of been at each other now for 4 years, going on five, whether it's been the tournament, regular season, or, of course, the Super back in 2009. They've kind of been the benchmark for a lot of things going on in that area. They'll play tonight for that championship at Oakville. The Rockets play on their home floor. Maybe down the road, it may not be being a regional, it might be in a sectional, it might be in a Super. Those two teams may get to cross paths again one more time in the postseason.
Well, and it's funny that you mentioned that, because that 1A Super out of the South does not know a team other than Oakville or Woodlawn being in it. It was Oakville in it the first 2 years, obviously clashed with Woodlawn for one of them. Woodlawn in it three straight years. So always a great barometer is that Oakville post-Thanksgiving tournament with Oakville and Woodlawn in mind. And a lot of great 1A games going on tonight in the area. A lot of great 3A games going on. Carbondale's at Cahokia, among others. And, you know, it'll be interesting to see how things turn out all across the South 7 tonight, because Marion and Althoff, I believe, will do battle. Sometimes that's a Tuesday night game, but I believe they are playing tonight. And it'll be interesting to see, after we get a quick glimpse of the conference landscape at tonight's action, to kind of get an early feel for where teams are going to be after their first matchup.
Yeah, it is. And again, it's the first matchup after a lot of tournaments right now. These teams getting together and battling. And you mentioned those games tonight as the South 7 opens up conference play. You're looking, of course, Mount Vernon's to Trey tonight. Carbondale is at Cahokia, and Marion is at Althoff. So you'll get to see early the road teams especially. And then, of course, Cahokia will open up. They should be the favorite. They are the favorite by many. So you take that into account. If Carbondale goes up there and plays well, what does that mean? If Marion can get Althoff, what does that mean? If Mount Vernon comes through here, you know, or vice versa on all three of these games, you'll learn a little bit tonight in the first games, but you'll go on from there.
Well, and Cahokia is a team that might be a little bit of a surprise right now, because they went into that tournament. Oh, my gosh. Can't believe I forgot where they went this year. Went somewhere up north. Wasn't Lincoln this year. But anyhow, Cahokia goes into that Thanksgiving tournament. Many expect them to come out of there that tournament champion. They come out of there, I believe, with a 2-3 mark. So Cahokia's a team that out of the outset is somewhat of a surprise. But they're young. They're projected to be a pretty good lineup, and possibly the South 7 Conference champions, maybe make a run in 3A.
Yeah.
But they're a team that struggled out of the gate.
It's the thing where you play in these early tournaments, and you don't know between football and not, and basketball and not, how many practices and whatever else. But, again, you don't know what you're going to get. And, again, there's a lot of expectations on Cahokia. Some teams deal with that well early. Some don't. Some have to grow into them. And, again, for me, until you get past the holiday tournaments here in about 3 weeks and get into January, where you have a barometer of about 10 to 12 games, that kind of tells me where teams stand. It's a little too early for me at this point in the season to start judging.
Exactly. And, of course, Althoff had that performance at the St. Anthony Thanksgiving tournament as we get the starting lineups. And I have to give you props. We're going to meet the Central Christian Church starting lineups, but normally, Mike McManus knows everything there is to know about Centralia. We got his advice on whom the starters might be tonight. And you noticed one thing going into tonight's game that would happen. And I'm proud to say that you had the starting lineup correct before we ever got here.
Well, I had some inside information previously in the evening given to me. And my source was very good as far as who would start and who would not. And we were given a starting lineup during the JV game that had a player in it, and I was told well into the afternoon or early evening that that player wouldn't be in for Centralia. And up on the scoreboard, that number is not listed tonight, so we'll leave that out and leave all the circumstances and everything else there. But, again, it's a different starting lineup. It's no biggie. It's just I have people and sources in a lot of different places, high school basketball.
Of course, again, as I said, it looks like some scores are already pouring in for our scoreboard update, which means you can find our scoreboard updates on Twitter. You can follow us at 94 Sports. You can also find the scores on Facebook. WMIX Sports is our Facebook page. We hope you'll like us there, as our Twitter posts often come across on our Facebook wall as well. It looks like we already have a final involving a Jefferson County team.
Yep.
Let's hear it. Yeah, the Ziegler-Royalton Tornadoes hosted the Weber Township Trojans tonight, and the Tornadoes beat the Trojans in a one-game varsity matchup, 55-30. So ZR beats Weber Township tonight in boys basketball, 55-30.
Of course, this is one of our favorite places to visit, the CHS Arena, where the Mountford and Rams tonight will take on the Centralia Orphans. The banner has been raised. We're about ready to go, about 2 minutes and 36 seconds away from our national anthem. as we continue this Rim Lake College pregame show. Chris Hugo and Danny Zawinski alongside MyWithersRadio.com, also your home for streaming audio of tonight's contest. The Orphans, meanwhile, again, as we said, come in a 1-4 record, struggled in that Crimson Classic. They will not be going there next year. Unofficially, they do have a new place where they're going to play in their Thanksgiving tournament. Cannot reveal that just now, but they will have a pretty impressive field in their next Thanksgiving home, and we can't wait to reveal that on the Saturday Sports Show.
There will be, and I'll go even further, you didn't know this, so I say this now, there will be waves of new ideas going on the next 2 or 3 years of Thanksgiving tournaments, not only involving 3A schools, but 2A and 1A in the entire area of Southern Illinois. And one of these tournaments involved that you're mentioning, and a bunch of other tournaments that involve us that are being mentioned as well.
I have a pretty good idea what you're going to tell me at some point off the air when you're allowed to tell me what it is based on some intel.
If you're that good, you can tell me lottery numbers, too, because I'm just guessing
based on your contacts, your this, that, and the other. I may not come within about 50 contacts, but you never know, and I'm going to try to pry it out of you in the car ride home. About 1 minute 19 seconds to go before we have our national anthem and our starting lineups here from the CHS Arena. We're glad to have you with us, regardless of how you may be accessing this broadcast. Thank you for making us a part of your Friday evening. December the 2nd, the Mount Vernon Rams and Centralia Orphans open South 7 Conference play. Typically, this does not happen, but it just happens to be the rotation is back here, with this one being the opening contest for the Mount Vernon Rams and Centralia Orphans, respectively.
Yeah, may as well play right out of the gate. You're going to have to play 10 anyway, so you may as well play one and see what you can do, and it's a good way to get together. A big crowd on hand for this one, top to bottom, bottom to top, and again, it'll be a good test for both teams to see where they stand after having 5 games early, a week of practice, and then turning around. Centralia, no easy chore this weekend. They got to go to Old Fallon tomorrow night.
That they do, and we're at St. Anthony tomorrow. We need to pause to honor America on the Rim Lake College pregame show. This is Rams Basketball on WMIX.
If you want a successful business, you need good partners. And if your need is printing, you won't find better partners than Mark and Carrie Smith.
Helping people is what we love.
But we need help with our financing.
That's why the Smiths and hundreds of local businesses trust Banterra. Banterra is the area's number one financial partner, offering commercial loans, treasury management, and remote deposit services. With Banterra as your partner, you can concentrate on what you do best. Banterra, banking with local style.
Equal housing lender, member FDIC.
All right, I want to ask you something, but you have to promise not to laugh at me.
Okay, what?
Do you think the State Farm jingle really works?
Like, for real? Like, if you sing the jingle, will your agent actually appear and help you out?
Yeah.
Of course it works. I saw it on the internet.
In reality, having your own State Farm agent means having a real person to help you when you need them. Tony Wilt is that State Farm agent at 4121 South Water Tower Place, Mount Vernon.
Hi, Roy Schmidt at King City Chrysler. When you think of the all-new Chrysler 200, the line imported from Detroit immediately comes to your mind. When it comes to character, comfort, and fuel efficiency, its capabilities extend well beyond its midsize shadow. This is not a style as a concept. This is design as a practice. This is the new Chrysler 200. This is a car that projects beauty beyond a footprint. Because when you build the new Chrysler 200, you have promises to keep. The all-new Chrysler 200 sedan is really an amazing automobile. Come into King City Chrysler today and receive huge cash discounts on 10 remaining 200s in stock, or receive 0% for 72 months. We may be able to lower your existing payment and you drive a new car. At King City Chrysler, 1603 Broadway in Mount Vernon, Illinois, where you can count on us.
Back out to the 94 Sports Mobile Studios on WMIX and MyWithersRadio.com.
And welcome back to the CHS Arena. Chris Hugo with Danny Zawinski alongside the Mount Vernon Rams on the road against the Centralia Orphans. And it is time now to meet your Central Christian Church starting lineup. Incredible things are happening at Central Christian Church in Mount Vernon. Look no further than thenewcentral.com. Watch their Friday night and Sunday services online. It's thenewcentral.com. Central Christian Church, loving God and loving people. Let's meet the Mount Vernon Rams.
Well, the Mount Vernon Rams tonight, the same lineup as Scott Camber had the last few games of the Pyramid Plus Tournament. The forwards will be 6'3", senior number 4, Clay Payne, 6'1", senior number 5, Leontay Badger, and 6 foot junior number 33 Trevor Floaty. Your guards will be 5'9" senior number 1 Tyrell Trimble and 5'7" junior number 2 Jaron Lydell for Scott Gamber's Mount Vernon Rams. Danny, I told you walking in that I'd never seen this place filled up, and you're going to hear how full it is if we meet the Centralia Orphans. The Orphans tonight will go with a 5-guard lineup. They will start at one of the five positions, 5'10" senior number 5 Brian Vett, 5'11" junior number 21 Charlie Avishi, 5'9" junior number 22 Jalen Webster, 6'1" sophomore number 24 Chase Alcorn, and 6'1" sophomore number 54 Jake Wood for Lee Bennett's Centralia Orphans. Starting lineups, each and every timeout are brought to you by Central Christian Church. Discover the excitement at Central. Central offers exciting worship experiences packed with energy and relevant teaching and awesome programming for children and youth. Check out the new Central.com for service time and more information. The Mount Vernon Rams and the Centralia Orphans getting ready to come your way as the Rams will be in their away black uniforms, orange trim, or numerals trimmed in white. The Orphans, meanwhile, will be in their home whites with red trim and red numeric, no trim. Officials for tonight's game, two-thirds of the trophy hunters, Jim Fisher and Tony Rodriguez of Casey. I don't believe I know the other one. This will be a new tour for me this year, so several things will be new.
It is packed.
It is.
Reminds me of trophy night at the holiday tournament, starting to get close to that kind of crowd.
Well, a lot of fans made their way up to support Scott Gamber's 4-1 Mount Vernon Rams, and many feel like this might be the Rams' chance to really show something to those keeping a close eye on the South 7 Conference race.
The thing I like to look at is student bodies, and in one section, if you're familiar here with the arena, the Mount Vernon Rams students have packed an entire section of bleachers, not but one section, all to themselves, top to bottom here in the upper deck. Very impressive. I would say they have more here than the Centralia kids in the orphanage.
Well, and we will see how the jump goes. It'll be Leontay Badger and Chase Alcorn for the Orphans. It's controlled in the backcourt by Centralia. Ivishi with the basketball, drops back for Betts. Betts and the Bohawk, pass it across the timeline. Now a throw to Alcorn on the left side. Betts with it up top. Left elbow for Owen. Looks around, finds Betts right wing, trying to get past Slidell. Over the near side, Ivishi. Back around, the left side will go. Alcorn finds Wood on the right wing. Back to the left wing, Alcorn. Webster with it on the far sideline. Back to Betts at the 10-foot line to Webster. He'll dribble in, 17-footers in route. It's good. The Orphans take an early 2-0 lead with 7:30 to play in the first.
They're going to play with a lot of emotion early, playing at home with the banner ceremony. You're going to have to match that and then play better if you're Mount Vernon.
Over there on the right wing, near it anyway, was Trimble. Back to Payne. Now on the near side, it'll be Lydell with the basketball. One dribble, stops at the wing, and it's a travel on the Rams. Turnover, Mount Vernon. It'll go back to the Orphans. It was 7:13 to play. They're hanging on to a 2-0 lead.
Now take care of the basketball. Little jitters early for both teams. A lot of nervous energy in this big rivalry.
Well, think about it. You practice all week in a closed-style gym, and you come here to with a great wide open at the CHS Arena. Webster with it. Right wing for Alcorn. He'll drive. He'll kick up to the left wing for Ivishi. Back to Wood. Right wing. Near side for Betts. Matched up in this man defense against Lydell. It goes around to Ivishi. Back to the right wing, Wood. Puts the ball back on the Wood and now gets back to the right side. Betts looking to drive baseline against Lydell. Shut off. Off the double team, throws to the right wing. Now a kick out coming around. It'll be left side for Webster. To Alcorn up top. Also has Ivishi out there. Now Wood with it, left elbow. He puts it back to the ground. Hands off to Betts. Now right wing, Alcorn wide open for three. No good off the mark. Rebound to Webster. Tipped out of bounds off of Tyrell Trimble. It'll be Orphan basketball. Rams basketball is presented by Bantera Bank. Tip off the season with a Bantera Bank free checking account. Bantera Bank, banking with local style, member FDIC. Wood gets the inbound. Coming out, Betts right elbow, kick out to Alcorn. Looks up top. Able to find Ivishi. Back to the right wing, Chase Alcorn. Now to Brian Betts on the near side. Orphans again going left to right with the basketball up 2-0. 6:18 to play in the first. Alcorn left wing. Looking around, Payne doing a good job on Alcorn. Now back to the far sideline, Webster. Webster looking in on Trimble, Rams in a man. And back to the near side, it will go to Ivishi. Now in the near corner, it's Betts looking inside Wood for the turnaround. No, he'll kick out. Right wing three coming. It's off the mark by Webster. Rebound tipped out of bounds by Betts. It's going back to the Rams. 5:55 to play in the first.
still 2-0 Orphans.
Yeah, you expect this one to be low scoring. These two teams kind of like to play a grind-them-out style, not a muscular or physical game, just a grind-them-out where each possession is very important from start to finish.
Lydell with it right side of the timeline, over the left wing for Payne. Orphans also in a man. You'll see them in switching man from time to time, thrown away inside the paint. What comes up the interception? Webster brings it across near side, drops it off for Alcorn, left wing. Right wing, rather. Now up top. Ibishi goes back to Wood. Wide open three on the way, off the mark, and he'll get the bounce to the iron. Orphans up 5-0. The Orphans take an early 5-0 lead here with 5:25 to play in this opening quarter. Nearly sold out CHS Arena. Left wing is Trevor Flota. Looking around. Has Trimble coming around, right in the circle. Crossover dribble. Trimble trying to drive. Pass to kick back out to the right side. Lydell there for the rescue. Now right sideline for Payne. He'll back it out with a left-hand dribble. Finds Flota here on the near side. Trimble trying to drive against Wood. Has it stolen from behind by Beck. Jump ball. And the possession arrow will favor the Rams. My, oh, my, the Orphans have come in and fired, up 5-0 with 5:01 to go here in this first
quarter. Well, it's the defensive effort. I mean, Centralia has not allowed Mount Vernon an easy pass or an easy look. Mount Vernon hasn't even attempted a shot until now.
Trimble, three on the way, is off the mark. Rebound, backdoor, Badger, put back, no good. Rebound to Flota, backdoor. And he'll stick it up, fouled by Betts on his way up. Trevor floated to the line. And the Rams will see if they can get back within three.
And this is not a very size-imposing team that Centralia will throw out there height-wise either. This is a team that Mount Vernon can crash the boards and have an advantage with guys like Flota and Badger.
Flota's first is off the mark. So the best they can do is make it a four-point game. Bantura's online banking is convenient, efficient, and best of all safe. Their security is your best defense, Bantura Bank. Banking with local style, member FDIC. Flota drains the second. Rams are back within four. It's 5-1 Orphans with 4:53 to play here in the first. Left side, Betts looks around, able to find Alcorn. Tipped away by Badger. He gets his first steal. Across the right timeline. And that's a good call by Tony Rodriguez, the official right side of the elbow. And Badger gets called for the travel.
Yeah, couldn't get his feet stopped fast enough. It is a travel.
Webster will lob in the Betts. 4:41 to play in the first. Glad to have you with us here on WMIX. 4:37 to go in the first. Rams trail 5-1. Betts looking to drive. Kicks down elbow. Finds the left side. That was McConaughey. Up top to Betts. Left side to McConaughey. Looking to dribble in. Shot off. Has to go to Ibishi right wing. Back to Wood left wing. Right hand dribble. Looking to come around. Guarded by Badger. Nearly gets a steal. Now picks up the foul. Got a little too aggressive that time. And that is Leontay's first. Team second, I believe.
An indifferent effort. You can tell Mount Vernon is kind of playing through the nerves, a legitimate road game, a conference game, big crowd. As you mentioned, you're shooting in an open arena. So it's a little different setup here for Mount Vernon, even though they play here all the time.
Betts looks left side, able to find Ivan McConaughey. Back to the right wing of Vichy. Looks left for Wood. Ball fake, gets back to the right. It'll be Webster. Looking inside on the Ram man defense. Up top, Ivan McConaughey looks back for Jalen Webster. He'll walk with the basketball since Ray turns it over. 4:01 to play in the first. 5-1 is the Orphan lead.
A little too fast there that time. One to go before he had the ball. Placed on the dribble. And, of course, again, the travel on both teams. Five turnovers. Three for Mount Vernon, two for Centralia as we play along here in this first quarter.
That'll happen. Length of floor to go for the Rams. Looking for a Community First Bank player of the game. Great traditions aren't given. They're earned through hard work and commitment. That's just what they believe in. Community First Bank, proud sponsors of the Rams. A great tradition. Up top, Trimble with the basketball, looks for the lob right side. There's Jaron Lydell. Left of the circle, it's Payne. Over to the left wing for Flota with 3:45 to go in the first. Still 5-1 Orphan. Crossover dribble by Trimble, try to drive, taken away by Wood in the lane. And here will come the Orphans. Another turnover on the Rams. Orphans will try to add to the lead. 3:30 to play in the first. Left wing, it is Jalen Webster. Up top, Jake Wood. Payne, three, looks to the near side, brings it with a dribble. Has McConaughey wide open on the ring. Uses the pivot to get it to him. Webster swings around left side for Alcorn. He'll come up top. Back to the right side. That is number 34, Jeff Rogers. Back to the far side now. McConaughey back to Alcorn. 3:06 to play in the first. Orphans content. We're just trying to keep the ball away from the Rams. Can't blame them. Rams to death to the Orphans for many years. Far side McConaughey, up top Rogers, a sophomore with the basketball. 2:51 to go in this first quarter.
Still 5-1 Orphan lead. Webster with it right in the circle near the timeline. And with 2:44 to play, he'll come to Rogers. Back to Alcorn. Looking for the slide pass. Chase gives it up to Clay Payne. Lydell will bring it across right into the circle. 2:33 to play in the first. Rams need a bucket in a big way. Between the leg, dribble now top. Hands off to Flota between the circles. Now back left wing for Clay. Payne gives back to Flota. Looking around, has Badger on the near post. Up top, Trimble. Back to the right side for Payne and 2:16 to play in the first. Pass down low. Badger, it's good. Off the right block, and Badger makes it a 2-point game. It's 5-3 Centralia.
Nice little setup there for the Rams. Nice to get a bucket in. It comes 6 minutes into the first quarter.
Far side, Rogers with the basketball for the Orphans. Comes up top, Webster, left elbow now, Wood. Looks back to the right wing, Webster three on the way. It's off the mark, rebound to Lydell. Lydell and Flota kind of fought for it for a second. Lydell will come away with it once Flota realized it was a friendly. Across the timeline we are. Lob down low, Payne all alone. We're tied. Clay Payne gets the tying basket, 5-5. 97 seconds to go in the first.
Mount Vernon doing a great job. As I said earlier in the quarter, Mount Vernon's got an opportunity with the height to get a rebounding advantage and even go inside offensively.
Right in the circle, it's Webster. Looks back around the left side. Rogers nearly has it stolen away. Recovered by Webster. Tipped around by the Rams. And a great play by Alcorn to keep it in. Webster with it right in the circle. 1:16 to play here in the first. Tied at 5. Rams and the Orphans here at the CHS Arena. We're still within the window. We'll tell you this is WMIX, Mount Vernon, Marion Effingham. A free service from Withers broadcasting. The Alcorn dribble drive comes up short on the left side. Rebound Mount Vernon. And here comes Jeremiah Dell with less than a minute to play in the first. Still tied at 5. Loader with it between the circles off a right-hand dribble. Tossed up to the right wing for Trimble. He'll back out with 48 seconds. Now back to the near side for Lydell. Scores over the right side now for Trimble. He'll drive right elbow. Looks right side for Badger. Going to use that body trying to get to the hoop. Can't. Gives right wing for Payne. 35 seconds to play in the first quarter. Rams 5, Orphans 5. CHS Arena, we're coming to you here on WMIX online at MyWithersRadio.com. And, of course, Banterra Bank is the official voice of the Mountford and Rams. And if you can't get to the bank during the half, don't worry. Bank in the stands with Banterra's mobile banking. Banterra Bank, banking with local style, member FDIC. 15 ticks to go in the first quarter clock. Crossover dribble and a no-look pass taken away from Trimble. Intercepted in the lane. Payne was all alone down low. Nothing they could do. Webster with it. Left of the circle is 4. Gets to Wood on the far corner. Three-pointer. The buzzer is good. And the Orphans take an 8-5 lead going into the second quarter. We are through 1. Centralia 8. Mount Vernon 5. This is Rams Basketball presented by Banterra Bank.
If you want a successful business, you need good partners. And if your need is printing, you won't find better partners than Mark and Carrie Smith.
Helping people is what we love.
But we need help with our financing.
That's why the Smiths and hundreds of local businesses trust Banterra. Banterra is the area's number one financial partner, offering commercial loans, treasury management, and remote deposit services. With Banterra as your partner, you can concentrate on what you do best. Banterra, banking with local style.
Equal housing lender, member FDIC.
This is Rams Basketball on WMIX with streaming video on MyWithersRadio.com.
And welcome back to the CHS Arena. We're through 1. Chris Hugo with Danny Zerwinski alongside as the Mount Vernon Rams trail the Centralia Orphans 8-5. What a first quarter there for the Orphans, Danny. Came out pumped defensively. Forced a few turnovers on the Rams, and the Rams fell behind early.
Well, the skill of 2 3-point shots made by Jake Wood has given Centralia this 8-5 lead. Mount Vernon's perimeter defense right now, they're going to have to shore it up because too many easy looks right now. Centralia has taken 5 3-pointers, and 4 of those 5 have been in the variety where nobody's been outside guarding them.
We'll start the second quarter. Centralia with the basketball. They got the big 3-pointer from Jake Wood near the buzzer to make it 8-5 and unlock the tie. And now they'll try to add more to it here as they get the ball to start this second quarter. Side out of bounds will come from half court. It's inbounded into the backcourt. Rogers. He'll bring it across left of the circle. Rams still in man. Looking for Betts on the near side. Comes to the wing. Betts off a left-hand dribble up top against Trimble. 7:49 to play in the half. Orphans with an 8-5 lead. Right of the circle now for Betts. Looks around to the left, finds Rogers. Now to Ivan McConaughey. And that'll be a foul on the reach by Clay Payne.
His first team second. And you can feel now the energy getting out of
both teams, that nervous energy, both teams starting to sweat and get into the flow of this game right now as we begin the second quarter a little bit more. Side out of bounds for the Orphans. Rogers will haul it in. Near side for Betts. He has the basketball. 7:35 to play in the first half. 8-5 is the Orphan lead. McConaughey with it. Left arc. Now back on the near side. That is Luke Stefanovic. And now a three coming from McConaughey. Far side. Rebound. Comes all the way to the right wing for Lydell. And so the Rams score themselves a rebound. And have the basketball with a chance to tie. And 7:15 to play in the half. Pike with it. Left side. Gives to Lydell. Lydell will come baseline, gets the bucket from the left block, and the Rams are within one, 8-7. Great opening dribble, left hand, left baseline, got around his man quickly, and the help side defense didn't come, and Lydell was able to bank it off the glass. That he was. Left side McConaughey looking around for Stefanovic. Stefanovic, there we go. Right side for Fetch. He'll throw up a three. It's good. Nothing but net, 11-7. The Orphans are up four.
And again, it's not a closeout. Mount Vernon daring the perimeter players to shoot to Trey with three threes tonight already, 9 of their 11 points.
Between the circles we go. It is Flota. Steps to the right wing, 6:28 to play in the first half, 11-7, your Orphan lead. Right of the circle. It's Lydell. Has Payne coming to the top. Switching man defense at times here from Lee Bennett, Centralia Orphan. Badger with him on the right wing. He'll drive. Looks back door for Pike. Gets out of bounds by Ivan McConaughey. It'll remain with the Rams. And I wonder where Lee Bennett got that switching man defense from.
Yeah, I wonder where he got that from. An old Pat Riley trick as well in the NBA. He has his guys switch.
Well, that's also something the Pittsfield Stuckies used to run back in the day. Tip in the Badger. It's good. Count the foul. Badger had a lob. Went up in the air to get it. Able to tip it in. And the Rams have a chance to be back within one on the and-one opportunity for Leonte Badger. And I will say it again, Danny. Leonte Badger, in his first season of experience for the Rams, has paid huge dividends.
And the thing there, that's a new inbounds play. Didn't see that last week. Something new, something crafty for the week when you play a conference team.
Well, a guy like Scott Gamber is always trying to stay one step ahead of the competitor. Badger good on the free throw. Back within one of the Rams. 11-10 with 6:08 to play here in the first half. Webster will bring it across, right of the circle, looks left for Betts. Now on the far sideline of Ishii. Steps to the wing, gives up top to McConaughey. Back to the left for Wood. Back up top, McConaughey, now right wing to Betts. Rams still in man. Left side of Ishii, now between the circles. Betts will get it right wing for another three. Off the mark, rebound Flota. And that is a big rebound for Trevor Flota. Rams down one, trying to take the lead here with 5:43 to play. First half action, right of the circle. Idell will hand off to Trimble. Dribble looking for the crossover in the lane. Looks backside for Payne. Not ready for it. And won't get the basket. He tried to rush the basket after he wasn't ready for the pass. Orphans get the rebound, and Webster brings it across. Left wing, it's Webster. Looks back to the right side. And now we'll have some contact. Looks like an offensive foul here on the Orphans in the turnover.
Now, gave away the ball, and when you give away the ball, you can't continue to move the guy you're with out of the way. And Jalen Webster, as he left the ball for Wood, kept going and pushed his guy out of the way as he was trying to set a moving screen, and it got called for it.
5:23 to play here in the first half. 11-10 is your score. Rams are down uno. Chris Hugo with Danny Zerwinski. Glad to have you with us on WMIX Audio Online at mywithersradio.com from the CHS Arena. Far sideline dribble between the circles for Payne. Orphan's still in the switching man. Back to the right side for Trimble. Almost had it stolen away by Webster. Trimble right arc, looking to make something happen. Has Lydell near the circle, and that's going to be a travel on Trimble. Probably a good call there by Tony Rodriguez.
Six turnovers on Mount Vernon right now, so that's the key in this one. I mean, Mount Vernon's got to cut their turnovers down and guard the perimeter a little bit better. And you look up, and you're thinking, okay, trouble here. Centralia has made those three threes, but Mount Vernon's only down one.
Far side, that is the issue with the basketball. Up top, Betts now right up, left elbow, rather, to Wood. Right wing, it's Betts. Kicks over near corner for Webster for three. Off the mark. Rebound by Badger. And the Rams have another chance here. 4:48 to play in the half. Down one. Orphans up 11-10. We'll see Rogers back in the game for Centralia here in a moment. Right side, it's Payne. Looking to drive baseline underneath. Goes reverse. Won't get the bounce. Trying to fight for the rebound. It's tipped away to Wood. Payne steals it away mid-post. Payne will kick out to Lydell. Flota wide open. 1-3. And now back to the circle for Lydell. Right side, here comes Badger trying to use that athleticism.
Goes back to Payne, now swung around in the left corner. There's Lydell. 4:18 to go in the first half. Rams with the basketball, not with the lead. They're down one. Orphans lead 11-10. Left wing, Badger almost should have probably been called for a walk. Goes to the basket. He's fouled. Badger goes to the line to shoot two, and he can take the lead and unlock the lead.
I want to point out, too, that a lot of times in basketball, teams will make some threes early, and they call that fool's goal because that team will start shooting more threes. Centralia continuing to attack from the perimeter. Mount Vernon tonight already with four baskets in the paint. 8 of their 10 have come from inside.
4:08 to play here in this first half, and we're tied as Badger. Leontay Badger makes the first free throw. Will he get the second? No, it rims out. Rebound went to Avishi, and here come the Orphans midway through the second quarter, tied at 11. We've been tied at 5, we've been tied at 11. Every other time, it's all Centralia. Alcorn with the right wing, gets to Rogers left wing. Trying to come between the circles, shifts back on his man as he cut back. Great tip out of bounds by Trimble, and the Orphans will retain possession. Don't support the other team. Go green with Bantura's online statements and online bill pay. Bantura Bank, banking with local style, member FDIC. Orphan basketball, 3:47 to play in the half. Far side is Rogers. Steps to the far wing, now gives over near side for Alcorn here on the wing. Sideline now to Avishi. Has Wood up top. He'll try to blow past his man. It says to Alcorn, near side, Wood down the lane. Got away with a walk. It's thrown out of bounds and a foul on the Rams.
Yep.
Oh, my.
Floated, got in there that time, was trying to double team. Had he remained there, he'd have been fine. But he reached in and hooked the arm of Wood underneath the basket after the double team, and that'll be his first foul.
Inbound will come from Rogers. Looks to the back door, able to find Alcorn here on the near sideline. Bounce pass outside the paint for Wood. He's on the near side looking for the cut to the back door. Instead, stolen away by Lydell. Has Floater coming up for a layup. Got the hook. Got the basket. Oh, and a travel. Rams turn the ball over. It'll come back with the Orphans. Still tied at 11 with 3:23 to play.
Well,
good move by Floater to the basket. Just took too many steps with the ball.
Well, and he was trying to corral the basketball. Lydell threw a great pass in traffic, and Floater grabbed it. Lost it for a minute, and then that process shuffled his feet to the rim.
Betts will bring up the basketball. Florida made almost a daring play there. Just didn't pay off. Left side Betts gets it back from Wood. Betts trying to come baseline, steps out of bounds, but there's a foul before that. And that will be, I believe, the fourth foul on the Rams. Support your Mount Vernon Rams with a Rams debit card for Community First Bank. Community First Bank is the only bank with debit cards tied to the Rams, with a portion of the revenue going back to Mount Vernon High School. Betts will trigger right of the basket. Once the back door, instead forces it into Wood. That was risky. Back to the right wing, it is Avishi with the basketball. Left hand dribble to the top. Continues around left side, stolen away by Payne. Has a 2-on-1, now the numbers even up. Payne loses the basketball. It should be a jump ball, should have been a travel before that. Possession arrow in favor of the Rams. They are lucky there and get to maintain possession of the ball.
Yeah. Very lucky in that case. Mount Vernon gets the jump ball and keeps the possession, as you said. Just kind of an odd play, but bodies flying everywhere. It's a case the ball wasn't under possession, so the referee couldn't blow a whistle.
Floater will trigger to the left of the Ram basket. 2:59 to play in the first half. It's inbound to Badger, and there he is again, right block. And the Rams take their first lead of the night, 13-11.
Like I said, Mount Vernon's the team attacking from the paint and scoring. Centralia made a couple threes early, wanting to live with that right now. It's fool's goal, at least right now, for the Orphans.
And we'll have a travel on the Orphans. It was McConaughey before he could get rid of the basketball. That is their eighth turnover tonight. And with 2:43 to play, the Rams can add to their two-point lead. We're in the first half in the CHS Arena. Chris Hugo with Danny Zerwinski. Online at mywithersradio.com on your radio here on WMIX. Right wing is Trimble coming around between the circles. Crossover dribble to the left elbow. Kicks over left baseline for Payne. He'll back it out to the arc. Now 10-foot line trickery there from Flota and Trimble. On the right side it is. Look at backdoor lob. Nobody there. And the Rams fail to capitalize on an opportunity.
Yeah, that's their eighth turnovers. We play even Stevens on the turnover battle. 13-11, 2:25 to go. It's a frustrating kind of game, but obviously, as we mentioned, a grind-them-out style game for the Mount Vernon Centralia, as we have seen over the last few years.
Very coy, Roy. You stole my name, Ryan, but that's all good. Like, great minds think alike, they say. It'll be number 5, Brian Betts, with the basketball for the Orphans. Comes to the top of the key as he crosses the timeline. Gives up to Wood. Now back right wing for Betts. Dribbles to the elbow. Kicks back Wood. Looking for the screen three. Ball fake, looking near side now for Alcorn. And Wood will travel the basketball. Turnover, Centralia.
Well, you know, the Orphans have only shot four times in the second quarter, made one. They've been all three-pointers. They've only made one.
It'll be Lydell bringing it up. We owe you some State Farm scoreboard updates. We'll get to that in the halftime show brought to you by Second Chance Auto. Left wing, it's Clay Payne. One dribble, gives over the right side, Lydell. At the 10-foot volleyball line, now comes near side, kicks out the elbow, back to the wing for Trimble. Drives right elbow. Still look past the floater for three. Fake it! It is 16-11. Rams up five. 1:44 to play in the first half.
Very nice. Like I said, inside first, outside second, the Rams are living it up in the second quarter.
Left side, it's Webster. He'll come with the basketball for the Orphans. Down five, 90 seconds to go in the second quarter. Between the circles, looks back left. Able to find Wood from McConaughey. He's outside the paint against Badger. Trying to work it in off the ball fake. Waits for the D to clear. And he travels with the basketball.
Yep.
Great shot. Defense there by the triangle of Payne, Badger, and Lydell.
The key was when the third guy came in, Wood had nowhere to go. Shot fake, got there, and then had to take his foot underneath, take the pivot foot off. That was the travel in the question.
It'll be Lydell bringing it up for the Rams. We may fall below the minute mark here. 1:10 to play in the half. Rams up 16-11. Trimble with it right wing. Drops off for Floaty. He'll come around left side. Stops at the 10-foot line. Up top to Badger with 1:05 to play. Looking around near side. Left-hand dribble. Badger with the basketball for the orange and black. They're in their away black tonight. Beautiful brand-new uniforms from a year ago. Orange trim. Orange number. 53 seconds to go in this half. Rams are up 16-11. We remind you, Rams basketball, as always, is presented by Banterra Bank. Nail a three. Go for the account with no hidden fee. Banterra offers a totally free checking account. Banterra Bank, banking with local style. Member FDIC. It's Badger with it. Right corner near the timeline and 35 seconds to play in the half. Rams are up 5, 16-11. Trimble with it. Off the double team. Slides right sideline for Payne. Get back to Trimble right of the circle. Still man here for the Orphans. No switch off at times. Primarily a man defense. For Lee Bennett's squad. Double team on Payne, far sideline, looking for somebody to get it to. Scott Gamber calls the timeout, and that is a well-placed timeout by Scott Gamber. 17.3 ticks to go in the first half. A nearly sold-out CHS Arena, where the Mount Vernon Rams lead 16-11 over the Orphans. The Ford F-150 boasts an exclusive EcoBoost engine, which means more power with better fuel efficiency. Test drive the large truck champion for over 34 years at Ford Square at Mount Vernon. You can count on us. This is a Ford Square timeout. And Danny, the Rams, though they fell behind early 5-0, come back to tie that. Then they fall behind, I believe, 11-5, come back to tie again. And since then, they're on that run to take a 16-11 lead, and it has been thankful due to their man defense forcing the turnovers on the Centralia floor.
It's one thing, like I said, the offensive thing, Mount Vernon's tightening up defensively. Centralia's not getting those easy looks. Now, what Centralia has done is they've only taken four shots in the second quarter. They have seven turnovers. And as I said, all four of them are behind the three-point line. They're living back there. Right now, it's not doing them very well.
Low to inbounds, side out of bounds, far side. Payne with it right of the circle. 13 seconds to play in the half. Rams are up 16-11. Cross-court pass coming from Badger to Lydell with seven. Left-hand dribble, shakes his man, kicks out right side. Triple with the three with four. Off the mark, rebound, tipped out of bounds. It's off of Badger. It'll be Ram basketball with 8-10.
Time for a tip play. That's about all. You might have a catch and shoot. It has to be quick.
And I know you're going to assume they look for on this one, possibly Badger. It'll be Payne to inbound, 0.8 seconds to go in the half. Rams up 5, 16-11. Lydell will come around. It'll be tipped out of bounds. The time will expire. So that'll be your first half score. The Mount Vernon Rams 16, the Centralia Orphans 11. This is Rams basketball on WMIX.
Does this sound familiar?
I can't stand this job. I just wish I had time to go back to school, but with work and family...
I know. I just enrolled in Rend Lake College's evening cosmetology program. They have evening classes that will even fit into your busy schedule. You can even graduate in less than 2 years. Classes are convenient to get to, and they're in Studio RLC in Mount Vernon. They even offer financial aid.
What's it like? I've been out of school so long.
It's not your typical take notes. Listen to a lecture program. We will learn the latest styles and trends in cosmetology, and looks like we'll have fun doing it. We'll be out on the salon floor getting hands-on experience and getting to know all kinds of people. By the time we're done, we'll be ready to jump into a new career and love our jobs for once.
Okay, how do I sign up?
I called 618-242-8459, but you can also check out their website at rlc.edu/studio-rlc or stop by the RLC Marketplace in Mount Vernon.
It's amazing how versatile the Saturday Sports Show has become. What do you mean you slept in last week? Set your alarm for 8:08 this Saturday morning and tune your radio to AM 940. More Mount Vernon Rams talk, more Jefferson County talk, and more amped-up coverage of Southern Illinois sports. Hear from the best coaches, experts, and sports know-it-alls available. Sports talk worth waking up for. Saturday mornings from 8:08 till 10 a.m. on WMIX AM 940 and online at mywithersradio.com. Presented by Crossroads Community Hospital.
Whether you're an Integra customer needing a new home or just tired of the constant changes associated with big corporate banking, you do have a choice. Hi, I'm Joe David Cummins with Community First Bank. We built our business around one goal, your needs. With five locations and a team of your friends and neighbors to support you, your banking solutions are handled right here at home. And to make your move easy, we have new account specials and personal bankers ready to help.
Community First Bank with locations in Mount Vernon, Woodlawn, Dix, and Ina. Welcome back to Personal Banking. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
If I could see into the future, you know what I want to know? I'd want to know how the whole thing is going to turn out. Did I make the right decisions for my business? Helping my daughter memorize all 50 states in alphabetical order. Did it really matter?
Understanding that the future is about planning, not worrying, is why Erie Insurance is above all in service. Auto, home, business, and life. Your Erie agent is waiting for you.
Your Erie agent in Mount Vernon is the Bean Insurance Agency. Get a quote at 242-6017.
It's going to be a nasty winter, so get the vehicle you can depend on now at Second Chance Auto. They have the vehicle you're looking for, probably priced under $10,000. And most have a 3-month or 3,000-mile warranty. And there's bank rate financing for everyone. Second Chance Auto has been helping people just like you for over 32 years. So get your quality pre-owned vehicle from Second Chance Auto today. Route 142 East in Mount Vernon or call 244-4582. That's 244-4582. This is Mount Vernon Rams basketball on WMIX. The Second Chance Auto Halftime Show starts now.
And good evening. Once again, from the CHS Arena, your score at the half, the Mount Vernon Rams 16, the Centralia Orphans 11. Chris Hugo with Danny Zawinski alongside for your Second Chance Auto Halftime Show. It's been a great year at Second Chance Auto. And if you haven't been by lately, the inventory has never been greater. Instant approval, no gimmicks, no pressure. Just honest deals at Second Chance Auto, Route 142 East in Mount Vernon. 16-11, your halftime score here. The 4-1 Rams lead the 1-4 Orphans. And Danny Zawinski alongside, I believe. We're going to go ahead and get to a State Farm scoreboard update.
All kinds of scores in the area tonight. The final at the DuCoin tournament tonight, Benton beats Caro 69-47. At the Oakville tournament tonight, it was New Athens losing to Marissa Coulterville 44-35. ZR beat Weber Township 55-30. Marshall County, Kentucky beat Harrisburg 72-58. Sullivan over Windsor 51-37. Here are partials at the half at Oakville. It's the Rockets leading the Woodlawn Cardinals 27-25. At the half, Fairfield over Johnson City 42-22. And one girls final tonight, Mount Carmel, Illinois lost to Marshall County, Kentucky 67-44. And the JV game here tonight at Centralia, the Rams win 33-27. Also at halftime score from a boys game, it is Salem 35, Newton 31 at the half. Also at the end of one, Pinckneyville leads Jabot 9-7.
We do have one more score out of the Southwestern Conference, the O'Fallon Panthers, who the Centralia Orphans will see tomorrow night, leads Granite City 33-21. That score is at the break. That scoreboard update presented by Tony Wilt, State Farm Insurance. Call Tony Wilt, your local State Farm agent. Find him on the web at TonyWilt.com or at the corner of 42nd Street and South Water Tower in Mount Vernon. If you see his red Jeep in the parking lot, stop in. He would love to meet with you. We'll take a break. When we come back, we'll have scoring and stats. This is the Second Chance Auto Halftime Show on WMIX.
Hometown proud Barovia's IGA. There's no better way to shop today, Barovia's IGA. If it's Barovia's, you know it's fresh for you and your family. If it's Barovia's, you got the best. We're hometown proud, you see. Hometown proud Barovia's
IGA. Hometown proud Veroviax IGA.
If you want a successful business, you need good partners. And if your need is printing, you won't find better partners than Mark and Carrie Smith.
Helping people is what we love.
But we need help with our financing.
That's why the Smiths and hundreds of local businesses trust Banterra. Banterra is the area's number one financial partner, offering commercial loans, treasury management, and remote deposit services. With Banterra as your partner, you can concentrate on what you do best. Banterra, banking with local style.
Equal housing lender, member FDIC.
With more in-game score updates than anyone else, this is Rams Basketball on WMIX.
And welcome back to the CHS Arena. Here at the half, the Rams, a 16-11 lead over the Centralia Orphans. The Second Chance Auto says they have the best selection of vehicles priced under $10,000. They mean it. The inventory has never been greater at Second Chance. Instant approval, no gimmicks, no pressure for 32 years at Second Chance. Jimmy Sawinski alongside. I'm Chris Hugo. Let's look at some scoring and stats presented by Heartland Accounting.
The Mount Vernon Rams were 5 of 8 from two-point range for 63%, 1 of 3 from the arc for 33%. Mount Vernon, 6 of 11 from the field in the first half for 55%. The Orphans, 1 of 2 from two-point range, 50%. They did not attempt a two-point shot in the second quarter. They go 1 of 3 from 3, or I should say 3 of 9 from three-point range, 33%. The Orphans go 4 of 11 from the field for 36% in the first half. Free throw shooting, Mount Vernon, 3 of 5 for 60%. The Orphans did not attempt a 3. Rebounding went to Mount Vernon, 9 to 4. And the turnovers, Centralia with 10. Mount Vernon with 8. The Orphans were led in scoring in the first half by Jake Wood with 6 points. He had 2 3-pointers in the first quarter. Brian Betts had 3, and Jalen Webster had 2. The Rams had 4 players score in the first half. Leonte Badger leading the way with 8 points and 3 rebounds. Trevor Flota had 4, Clay Plain 2, and Jaron Lydell had 2. To give you a halftime score of Mount Vernon 16, Centralia 11. Get started right. Let Heartland Accounting help make your business a success. Heartland Accounting, 3000 Broadway, Suite 2B, your small business expert. This is your Second Chance Auto Halftime Show. The Mount Vernon Rams 16, the Centralia Orphans 11. We'll take a break. Get you set for second half action. This is Rams Basketball on WMIX.
Change is good. Change is also easy with People's National Bank Switch Kit. Simply follow a few easy steps to discover what banking with a true community-focused bank is like. Hi, this is Star Reed with People's National Bank in Mount Vernon. Stop by and let me show you how easy it is to start banking with People's National Bank. People's National Bank, member FDIC.
When you want the best, think the Orthopedic Center of Southern Illinois. The Orthopedic Center has the unique distinction of being one of only 2 non-academic accredited orthopedic teaching and research facilities in the state of Illinois. Our goal in education is to inspire the next generation of orthopedic surgeons. Patient care, education, and research are our core strengths. Located on Veterans Memorial Drive, Mount Vernon, and St. Mary's Good Samaritan, Centralia Campus. The Orthopedic Center of Southern Illinois. Discover the difference.
Daily schedules, scores, and more. Like WMIX Sports on Facebook. Back to the Rams on WMIX.
And welcome back to the CHS Arena. The Mount Vernon Rams have a 16-11 lead over the Centralia Orphans. And if you have been by Second Chance Auto lately, you're missing out on instant approvals, no gimmicks, and no pressure. Just honest deals on great vehicles. For 32 years, it's Second Chance Auto, Route 142 East in Mount Vernon. Danny, it was rough at times for the Rams there in the first half. Down 5-0 at one point, 11-5 at another. Since then, have taken a 16-11 lead. What can they do in that second half to maintain and or gain some on the Centralia Orphans?
The approach was good all the way through. I think Mount Vernon was patient and worked their way into the paint to take advantage of the height advantage they have. What they forced Centralia to do, the Orphans made a couple of threes, one at the end of the first quarter. Then Centralia relied on that three-pointer, and they turned the ball over 7 times. I think what Mount Vernon has to do is to keep Centralia befuddled out there on the perimeter right now. They've got him pushed out away from the basket. Centralia has not been able to get to the rim. Number two, if you're sent Mount Vernon, you've got to get in the hands of Badger and Trimble, break down, maybe go a little two-man game, then work it out to Flota as well as to paint. I mean, you can do some different things here in this contest, and I think Jaron Lydell is going to be a big factor in the second half. He can pressure the defense and pressure the guy that brings the ball to the floor for the Orphans into something they don't want to do.
And it'll be Centralia basketball to start this second half.
They go right to left as you look at your radio, and it'll be Webster inbounding to Betts. He'll bring it across at the circle. We are just underway with second half action. Now Vernon 16, Centralia 11. Betts kicks to the outside, finds Webster. He'll bring it around. Left, right of the circle, hands off to Betts, back to Webster at the 10-foot line. Looks around, comes near wing for Owen. Wood, I mean. Alcorn with the right wing, looks left wing now for Ivichi, back to the right wing for Betts. Has Wood on a back cut. Now gets back left wing for Ivichi. Right wing for Wood. Webster came underneath the basket. Now Alcorn pulls up for three left wing. It's good. And back within two are the Orphans. 16-14.
The Orphans have feasted on that three, but also in stretches. Again, they haven't hit it. They've gotten another one, but again, they have not taken a two-point shot since the first quarter.
They've come out of every break hot with that three. We'll see if it continues here for Centralia. Right side, it's Lydell. Has to come get the basketball and a bounce pass from Treble. Steps to the near wing, kicks left of the circle for Payne with 6:55 to play in the third. Still 16-14, Rams on top. Lydell with the basketball on the right side. Goes between the circles, looks left wing, finds Treble. That's Floto on the right, Payne, rather on the right, Floto is on the left. Down low, Badger along the baseline, and the Rams lead back up to four. It's 18-14. Across the right timeline, it's Betts with it for the Orphans. 6:31 to play in the third. Looks to the right wing for Alcorn. Left-hand dribble, steps up, gives off to the left arc now for Ivichi. Back to the right wing, it's Wood. Left side will be kicked around to Betts, looking for Wood mid-post. Possibly a turnaround coming, Jake Wood. Uses that pivot, puts it down, now trying to lean in, off the window, it's good.
Got Badger in the air, leaned into him to get contact. Badger couldn't handle the strength that Wood throws at him, and Badger gave up that basket. Actually, Wood did a better job of scoring.
18-16 is your score. Rams up to 5:58 to play here in the third quarter. Floto, a little bit of trouble with Beth. Gives off to the right wing for Badger. Looks around, has Trimble coming around at the circle, and Trimble will come back to the right wing for Lydell. Looks left. Floto going to come around with it up top. Finds Badger here at the 10-foot line. Now right of the circle, hands off left side. Trimble looks for Lydell down low. It's shut off by Alcorn, and on we go. Near sideline, it's Floto. Left of the circle, back to Lydell. 5:30 to play in the third quarter. Floto wide open for three. Good! Floto has two threes on the night. It's 21-16. The Rams are back up five. Timeout Scott Gamber. It's a 30-second timeout presented by King City Chrysler. King City Chrysler has the all-new Dodge Caliber. Caliber cranks up the sedan and exudes attitude with every turn. Receive huge cash discounts on the all-new Caliber King City Chrysler in Mount Vernon. Danny Zerwinski alongside. I'm Chris Hugo. We'll pause for station identification. This is Rams Radio.
The best basketball coverage is heard here. This is 94.1 FM WMIX Mount Vernon and worldwide at mywithersradio.com. A free service from Withers Broadcasting.
Thanks. Trevor Floto has done well here tonight. Danny is shooting three. He has two, I believe, 6 points on the night for Trevor Floto. He makes it 21-16 and brings that five-point lead
again,
back to the Rams.
Again, but Mount Vernon's going inside-outside, attacking in and then out. And that's the key in this. Centralia is having trouble defending both spots. Mount Vernon's getting a lot more easy looks right now than Centralia, who's backed up and is starting to rely on the three-pointer more.
Left side for the Orphans. Alcorn coming around to the top. Gives over to the right wing. Webster with a left-hand dribble. Kicks out Alcorn. Looking for three. No. Steps in. 12-footer on the way. No good. Rebound will be tipped around off of Betts. It'll be Trimble. And a huge rebound there defensively for the Rams. Trimble brings it across. Stops up top. Has to float to left side. Lydell looking to attack the basket. Instead, kicks out to the right wing. Trimble with a ball fake. Nice little head fake there by Trimble. Trying to make something happen. Left side, Lydell with the basketball for the Rams. They're up 5, 21-16. 4:46 to play in the half. Third quarter, rather. Game has gone so quickly, I almost forgot it was the third quarter. Left side, Lydell trying to drive all the way. The basket uses that athleticism on the reverse, and it's 23-16. Largest Ram lead of the night at 7.
Rams getting to the rim. That's the difference in this one. Centralia relying on the outside shot, Mount Vernon's ability to get in the paint and get into the rim.
Ivichi looks for Alcorn on the near side. Has it at the elbow. Kicks out to Betts on the wing. Left side for the Orphans. They're down 7, 23-16, midway through the third. Wood, pull-up three, coming wide open. Clanks off the front of the iron. Betts stripped away on the rebound. And he was in the act of shooting, apparently, so he'll go to the line to shoot two. If you miss getting to the bank at the half, don't worry. Bank in the stands with Vantura's mobile banking.
Banterra Bank, banking with local style, member FDIC, as they are the official voice of the Mount Vernon Rams. Betts at the line to shoot two, down 23-16. This could put the Orphans back within five if he can drain both. First one off back iron. Now, the Orphans, as I mentioned, it's hard to believe we're halfway through the third quarter, and the Orphans have only taken two-point shots so far. Trying to live by the three. They may die from the lack of interior presence. As Betts knocks down the second at 23-17. Six-point game midway through the third.
Centralia was trying to take it out of bounds after they made the free throws. Good try, though. That was a heck of a try by Mr. Webster.
Ram basketball here. 4:06 to play in the third, up 23-17. Payne will bring it across left side. Good crossover dribble. Trying to work it down low and take it himself. He's fouled in route. And that will be side out of bounds, I believe, on the near side.
Yeah, too much contact reaching in, riding around, and that was a foul there on Webster, which will be his second.
Of course, whether retirement is years or months away, open a retirement account that fits your lifestyle perfectly. Banterra Bank, banking with local style, member FDIC. Right in the circle, it is Lydell. Gets off to Trimble. Looks around, finds Lydell, loses the basketball, gets the dribble, now straddles that timeline, trying to find some help. Pass Betts on him. Lydell shakes Betts, gets to the layup. Good, and he's fouled. The Jaron Lydell show may have just premiered here in the third quarter. 25-17. Could be nine if he knocks down the free throw.
Told you he was a key. He was starting to feel some things late in that first half as far as able to get to the rim, starting to feel out the guy that was guarding him a little bit. And he has taken full advantage of that in his third quarter. Right now, Lydell with 4 points, looking to go for his fifth in the quarter and seventh in the game.
Could be your Community First Bank player of the game. Come start a banking relationship at Community First Bank. You won't be disappointed. Community First Bank, locations in Mount Vernon, Dix, Woodlawn, and Ina. Welcome back to Personal Banking. No good on the and one for Lydell. Rebound Centralia. Betts with it left wing. Finds McConaughey. Up top, it's Rogers. Looks left elbow. Finds Wood. Wood is a left sideline, gives to Rogers, and he'll run right into Lydell, who will pick up his foul.
A little too much contact that time. Lydell cut him off and unfortunately stopped and plumped into the dribbler. That'll be his second foul.
The Ram lead with 3:27 to play in the third is 25-17. McConaughey with a left wing. Cross-court pass to Betts. Right-hand dribble, trying to get past Bain. Throws up on a runner, gets the bounce and counted. And Centralia can formulate a three-point play of their own. And be back within five if Betts can knock it down.
First two-point shot Centralia has made since the first quarter. And that's the second foul on Clay Payne.
Betts is at the line to finish off the and one. No good on the free throw. Rebound will go to Payne. So the lead stays at six, 25-19. 3:16 to play in the third. Payne with it in the backcourt, looking across the timeline, met by Rogers. Centralia in man. Floater with it on the near side. Left-hand dribble, finds on the far wing, Trimble. Steps to the elbow, trying to get the layup. He's stripped, kicked out to Payne. Great play by Trimble to recover. Lydell with it at the 10-foot line. We'll fall below the 3-minute mark here. Third quarter action. 25-19, the Ram lead. Badger with it. Left side for Payne. And too far on the stop. Payne will travel with the basketball, turnover Ram. We have plenty of scoreboard updates coming your way, and they are all brought to you by Tony Wilton State Farm Insurance. You can find Tony Wilt on the web at TonyWilt.com or at the corner of 42nd South Water Tower in Mount Vernon. And if you see that red Jeep in the parking lot, stop in. Tony would love to meet with you. Left of the circle, it's Betts for the Orphans on the side out of bounds. Right side for Alcorn. Looking around, right of the circle, finds Betts, 2:42 to play in the third. Rams lead is 6. It's 25-19. Webster, able to go. Stefanovic on the right wing. Alcorn with it. Left elbow. Kicks out. Finds Webster. He'll drive baseline. Runs into Payne. Should be a charge. It'll be a block. Looks like Payne got his feet set, but he was too far outside, apparently. And it'll be a block.
That's his third foul. Fourth on the Rams in the quarter. Mount Vernon right now is shooting eyes. 4 of 4 from the field in this quarter. Their only shot they missed is a free throw.
McConaughey with it. Left side. Looking for Stefanovic in the lane. Off the block. It's good, and the Orphans are within four. I started to tell you that Marion is over Althoff, 31-25 at the half, but you posted that on Twitter. Follow us at 94 Sports. Good stuff.
Rydell with it across the circle. Hands off to the right side for Trimble. Rams only up four, 25-21. Orphans trying to come back here. Doing a good job of it thus far. Payne with it left wing. We drop below the two-minute mark here in the third quarter. Payne back to the circle. And the Ram offense looks flustered here against the Centralia man. Rydell comes back to the near side. Lost bet. Trimble will lose it in the lane. And the Rams had a golden opportunity after dropping Betts near the backcourt. And Betts will bring it across the timeline on the Ram turnover. Left wing, it's Webster looking down low. Stefanovic has to go right wing. That's McConaughey. Now Stefanovic for three. It would be big. No good. Rebound to Payne. And that's a big defensive board by Clay Payne. I think he has three.
And I don't think that's the shot Lee Bennett wanted that time.
I think you're right. 1:17 to play in the third. Slota looking to drive. Kick to the left side. Finds Rydell. He'll get it to Badger. Great wherewithal by Viante to back out with nothing there. Slota with it far side. Rydell had a great way to find Badger down low too. Badger with it on the far wing. Finds Slota coming across to the corner. Now left of the circle it is Rydell with 56 seconds remaining in the third. Ram lead is shrunk to four, 25-21. Trimble with it far wing. Now comes back right arc, finds Rydell, no look over to Payne, near side. Now a bounce pass to Trimble, left 10-footer. Back on the right wing, it is Rydell. Got it from the 10-foot line from Trimble. Now trying to work back to that 10-foot line, does so between the circles, left wing for Badger. Leonte, one step, goes to the right side for Payne, 29 seconds to go in the third. Payne with a left-hand dribble, switches to his right, comes back near side. Now back to the circle, trying to make something happen, gets past the hook. Backdoor for Badger. Oh, almost had it. Rebound will be tipped away to Alcorn. In and out by Badger. Scott Gammer not pleased, but there wasn't much more that Leonte Badger could do.
Wasn't much more than Mount Vernon could do there either. Ran the right play.
Alcorn wide open for three. Off the mark. Rebound tipped away. Badger throws up a shot as he falls. Stefanovic recovers. Right block and good. And that is how your third quarter will end. Stefanovic off the block. Centralia within two. We've reached the end of three. The Mount Vernon Rams 25, the Centralia Orphans 23. This is Rams Basketball on WMIX.
On November 5th, Community First Bank and the First State Bank of Dix officially partnered to better serve our customers and our community. Hi, I'm Joe David Cummins, President of Community First Bank. We welcome all our new friends to the Community First family. And I'd like to personally invite you to call, log in, or drop by any of our five locations to learn more about Jefferson County's only true, locally owned community bank.
Community First Bank with locations in Mount Vernon, Woodlawn, Dix, and Ina. Welcome back to personal banking. Member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Hometown proud, Borowiak's IGA. There's no better way to shop today, Borowiak's IGA. If it's Borowiak's, you know it's fresh for you and your family. If it's Borowiak's, you got the best. Well, hometown proud, you see. Hometown proud, Borowiak's IGA. Hometown proud, Borowiak's IGA.
For more scores and insight, follow us on Twitter at 94Sports. Now back to the Rams on WMIX.
And welcome back to the CHS Arena. Fourth quarter action. Chris Hugo with Danny Zerwinski alongside. The Mount Vernon Rams hanging on to a 25-23 lead. Stefanovic for the Orphans. Right block at the buzzer. Brought it back to a two-point game. It'll be Ram basketball to start. Side out of bounds to the half court. Loda inbounds to the backcourt to Lydell. He'll bring it across. Goes back left side. Once Trimble finds him. Now back to the right wing. It is Lydell. Left-hand dribble trying to get below past Rogers. Goes near sideline for Clay Payne. That floated in the corner. Tipped away from Payne by Betts. Betts awfully aggressive. Scott Gammer wants a foul. No call. Right wing. Trimble. Kicks over to Badger. Nice kick out up top to Lydell. Back to Badger. Trying to come baseline. Throws up a jumper. No good. Rebound floated. Tipped away. It'll be Betts. Orphans can tie or take the lead here with 7:23 to play in the fourth. Left side, Ivan McConaughey. Up top, Rogers. Left elbow, it's Jake Wood. Dribbled off of Wood's foot. It should be Rams. It'll be Orphan basketball. Last touch by the Orange and Black.
Crucial point in the game. I think you're going to see a run here by somebody in this close game to get maybe a 6-8 point lead. It's not going to be much. Lead like two right now is like a 4-point lead or six.
Alcorn will trigger in front of the Orphan bench. Backcourt to Webster.
Man defense for the Rams here. Alcorn gets it back left wing. Looking to drive baseline. Trying to get past Floater. We're tied. All the way to the left block. Pull up Jay, and we're tied at 25. 7:03 to play in the fourth.
Possession by possession. Here we go.
Always a thriller here at the CHS Arena. Rams won here last year 40-38 in double overtime. Between the circles, it's Payne. Bouncer on the near side, dribble. Goes up against Wood. The J, no good. Rebound Centralia. And the Rams, unable to get anything going offensively, trying to turn it into a track meet. 6:30 to play in the fourth. Tied at 25. Betts with it right in the circle. Looks around at the sideline, trying to go baseline. Walks with the basketball. The Rams will get it right back. Rams basketball course is presented by Bantera Bank, where the retirement is years or months away. Open a retirement account that fits your lifestyle perfectly. Bantera Bank, banking with local style, member FDIC. Across the timeline, it's Trimble. Dangerous pass stolen away by Betts. Stripped away by Trimble. Off the Betts, out of bounds. Should be Rams basketball. Then it goes back to the Orphans.
And a different wrinkle that time. Lee Bennett masks the defense by bringing up man. It looked like it was going to be full court man-to-man. As soon as Trimble crossed the timeline, they rolled an extra guy over. He didn't see it coming through the pass, and it was stolen. And a turnover to Mount Vernon, their first of the fourth quarter, but their third of the second half.
And my apologies, from my perspective, looked like it was off of Betts, but they give it to Centralia. They were on top of it. McConaughey looking for the lob, intercepted by Badger. Saw it time and time again on the gridiron, converted over to the basketball floor. He'll cross the timeline near side. Looks left, finds Lydell. Now back over the far sideline. There's Floda, 6:06 to play, 25-25. Tied at the arena. In front of the scorer's table, it's Lydell. Left-hand dribble, trying to get past Betts, kicks over to the far side. Floda comes around to the elbow. Gets back to the wing, up top, Payne. Back to the left wing for Trimble with 5:50. Side at 25. Rams with it in the front court. Trimble trying to cut over, gets to the elbow far side, stopped by Stefanovic. Great recovery there by Badger, left, right of the circle. Left side we go. Lydell with it. Steps to the right wing, hands off for Floda. Possession by possession is what it'll be here. Looking for that left elbow, it's Payne. He is fouled by Webster, and I believe that'll be just the third on Centralia.
Third on Webster in the game. And here's what, you know, Mount Vernon's going to have to do here. Centralia's picked up the defensive intensity. They have pushed out Mount Vernon a little further away from the basket each trip down the floor in the second half. And Mount Vernon right now is not getting those inside looks that they got in the first half.
It's lobbed into Floda, gets right wing. Trimble will pull up the free throw line, no good. And we have a foul on Clay Payne down low. That's his fourth. Not sure what to make of that. Not the shot Scott Gamber wanted. He's up pacing.
And you get a fourth foul on Clay Payne. That's not going to help things much.
It'll be Webster to trigger. Length of the floor to go. I thought it was his fourth. My apologies. Oh, no, that we've had a foul. Yeah. It is what it is. Coming near side. In the backcourt still for Beck. He'll bring it across in front of the scorer's table near side. Gets to the wing with 5:07 to go in the fourth. Tied at 25. Rams and Orphans. Webster with a right timeline. Now between the circles. Got away with a travel. And that'll be a foul on the Rams. It'll be on Jaron Lydell. Rams basketball course is presented by Bantera Bank. Don't foul out. Take control of your health care expenses with a tax advance self savings account. Bantera Bank, banking with local style, member FDIC. Betts will trigger, 4:59 to play. Left of his own basket, backdoor Webster, he's fouled by Trimble. And the foul differential will continue to grow here. That'll be the seventh on the Rams.
Yeah, more importantly, it's Centralia the line to try to get their first lead since the first quarter. And right now, Centralia's offense has given Mount Vernon fifth defensively, and the Rams right now just can't cover.
At the line, it's Webster misses his first. Winning Edge can customize just about any activewear, like a t-shirt or a hoodie for the team, organization, or just for you. Don't believe me? Visit them online at winningedgeusa.com. Quality service and fast turnaround since 1977. Webster goes one of two. That trip to the line unlocks the tie, and it's 26-25 Orphans.
Now Centralia again is going to pick up. They're going to initially show full court man-to-man. We'll see if they switch into something else.
Lydell with the basketball off of the inbound. Gets back to Payne. Payne back to Lydell. Now we cross right side. 4:50 to play. 26-25. Orphans by one. Payne to Trimble there near the baseline. He's going to back it out at least to the wing there on the far side, trying to get past Ivishi. Shake pass, kicks over to Floda for three, no good. And the rebound goes to Wood. Orphans with the basketball. They can add to the lead here. Up one, 26-25, 4:25 to play in the quarter. Right side, that's Charlie Ivishi. Looks around, had Betts up top. It'll be Rogers coming around from the left side. He'll back it up timeline. Now go left wing for Chase Alcorn. Back to Rogers. Kicks over to Charlie Ivishi. Up top to Alcorn again. Bounce pass right elbow for Wood. Left side, Alcorn wide open for three on the way. It was tipped, no good. Rebound by Badger. And here come the Rams midway through the fourth, down one.
Big rebound. That's the first one for Mount Vernon, and we're over halfway through the last part of this quarter.
Who will be your Community First Bank player of the game? Community First Bank with more Jefferson County locations than anyone else, as Leontay Badger will travel with the basketball, turnover Rams. Of course, locally owned Community First Bank of the Heartland is, with decisions made here. Proud supporters of the Mount Vernon Rams and Jefferson County, with locations in Ina, Dix, Woodlawn, and two branches in Mount Vernon. Centralia with a length of the floor to go.
Yeah, Trimble's measuring up Webster right now. And Webster's kind of been in a pattern about how to bring the ball to the floor, and Trimble right now is reading Webster like a book.
Betts with it in the backcourt. He'll bring it across left timeline. 3:37 to play. Right of the circle, it is Webster. Far side coming around. It was Ivishi up top. McConaughey right wing to Wood. Swung back around. It'll be Webster with the basketball. Looking down low. Has Wood in the paint. Out of the paint as he slid on the jump. And he travels with the basketball. Turnover. It'll go back to the Rams down 26-25,
and
3:22 to
Lee
go.
Lee Bennett's arguing he was on his dribble, but he was picking his dribble up trying to bounce back, and you can't do that. He was trying to get to the rim but couldn't, but a turnover, and Mount Vernon opportunity to take this lead.
Left side, it'll be Trimble. He'll get across. Left of the circle, coming around down low. It's Clay Payne with the basketball. Looks back around, cuts back to the basket, posts up, no good. Blocked by Wood. Centralia rebound. Clay Payne too hesitant that time, and the Rams were looking to take the lead there with an easy two. Now still down one, less than three to play in the fourth. Left wing is McConaughey. Steps up top against Payne. Looks to the left wing for Beth. Up top it goes. Nice no-look pass by Ivishi, left wing for Wood. Right side now, it's Ivishi as he gets it back. Kicks out to McConaughey, far side. 2:44 to play in the fourth quarter. It's 26-25. Detroit will throw it away. Ram basketball, 2:38 to go. Here in this fourth quarter, plenty of scoreboard updates coming your way in the post-game show. Of course, for all of your insurance financial service needs, call Tony Wilt, your local State Farm agent. Find him on the web at TonyWilt.com or at the corner of 42nd South Water Tower in Mount Vernon. If you see his red Jeep in the parking lot, stop in. He would love to meet with you. Payne with the basketball coming right wing. Dishes off in front of the Ram bench for Floda with 2:29 to play in the fourth. Ramp down 26-25. Floda got to the circle, has to cut back to the near side for Payne. Bounce pass, going left volleyball sideline for Trimble. He'll roll between the circles, now cuts back to the far side, trying to cut towards the basket off the block. He's fouled, and the foul will be on the floor. Just the fourth on the Orphans as a team, with 2:13 remaining in the fourth quarter. Still a one-point ball game favoring the Orphans, 26-25.
The matchup that Mount Vernon can exploit with Trimble and Lydell, if they can get their man one-on-one isolated on a wing, they can go either direction to get to the rim. Speed advantage to those two right now in their matchup.
Floda feigns a backdoor lob. Long deuce by Trimble rims in and out from the far side. And the 17-footer falls into the hands of Wood. He'll get back to Betts. He'll bring it across the timeline.
Mount Vernon does not have a field goal in this quarter, 0 for 6.
The third quarter ended 25-25. Both 1 point combined between the two teams as Wood is fouled at the 10-foot line. Near side by Leontay Badger.
1-1 for the Orphans. Mount Vernon's offense has escaped them after going in the third quarter 4-for-5, have went 0-for-6 here in the third.
Wood will go to the line to shoot the one in bonus with 1:57 to play here in the fourth quarter. Orphans hanging on to a 26-25 lead. And he will miss the first rebound. Will go. Won't matter. It'll be a foul on Jake Wood.
It will not be a foul. Jake Wood got to the rim before the ball hit the rim.
Ah,
he was crossing the line and firing away, and that Rams will be prospering on that.
I appreciate that. Bar in the way. Lydell will get the inbound. 1:54 to play in regulation. 26-25. Orphans on top. Lydell brings it across. Has it stolen away, and now an over and back. Rams fans not happy because Lydell was pushed. No call on the foul, and it goes back with Centralia. I have to say, I think they're right.
They got it right. Call was definitely right.
He was going over and back regardless. A push would have made no difference. Inbound will come in front of the scorer's table. Orphans within the backcourt. Could have been a foul there on Lydell. Betts will cross far corner. 1:38 to play. 26-25. Orphans by one. Left side it is. Webster back to the right wing. Now for Wood. He has the basketball for plenty of time. 85 seconds to go here in the fourth. And to the line will go Jake Wood again. One in bonus.
Wow. That will be the ninth, the 1-1, on a polite hand check by Leonte Badger.
At the line, Jake Wood shooting the front end of a 1-1 bonus, and he will miss this one. Rebound to Badger.
Whew.
Up the left side will come the Rams. It's Clay Payne with the basketball in the backcourt across the timeline. It will be Lydell, and Scott Gamer wants a timeout. This timeout is presented by Ford Square. The Ford F-150 boosts and boasts rather an exclusive EcoBoost engine, which means more power for better fuel efficiency. Test drive the large truck champion for 34 years at Ford Square of Mount Vernon. You can count on us. 26-25 Orphan. 1:14 to play in regulation. We have had 1 point scored in what has been a very, very choppy and, dare I say, ugly fourth quarter for both teams.
Well, it's not been ugly for Centralia. They have 3 points, but Mount Vernon right now from the field, as I said, 0-6 in this fourth quarter. And again, this was after a hot shooting third. The offense has completely gone away. Mount Vernon's not been able to get to the rim, not been able to get their shots. Centralia made an adjustment in their defense, varying the ways they've been throwing the man-to-man defense at Mount Vernon, whether it's full court or then rolling a guy as soon as Mount Vernon crossed the timeline to trap. All have caused Mount Vernon fifth here in this fourth quarter.
It is the top of the hour. We'll pause for station identification. This is Rams Radio.
Follow us on Twitter at 94 Sports or crank us up on 94.1 FM WMIX, Mount Vernon, Marion, O'Fallon, a Withers Broadcasting Superstation.
CHS Arena, 1:14 to play in the fourth quarter. Chris Hugo with Danny Zerwinski alongside. Orphans with a 26-25 lead. It's Ram basketball at the timeout. Side out of bounds in front of the scorer's table. That's the near side. Into the near corner for Trimble. Back to Flota. Swung around to Payne at the 10-foot line. Now back right side. There's Trimble. 108 mark of the fourth. Rams are down one. 26-25. Back to the left side. It's Payne. He'll look around, ride the circle, find Badger. Badger to the left. He's fouled by Alcorn.
Polite hand check the other way, so it's all even on both sides. And that's what we like to see, a consistent crew. We've enjoyed it tonight.
59.3 seconds to go here in regulation. 26-25. Flota needs some help. It'll go in the backcourt to Lydell. Betts is there to greet him. Comes around on the near side, a pass to Payne in front of the Ram bench. Baseline not wide open. Instead, have to go back to the near corner scorer's table for Trimble with 48 seconds. He's trying to cross over. Kicked out. Badger will travel with the basketball. He was able to get to the basket. He just took too many steps.
Yeah, now Mount Vernon has to decide what they want to do. Are they going to try? They'll go for a steal here. Centralia gets it in and goes. How early do you foul?
Length of the floor to go for the Orphans. Webster gets it in to Alcorn in the backcourt. Three Rams there to greet him. Alcorn will get bailed out by the timeout by Lee Bennett. This timeout is presented by King City Chrysler. Imported from Detroit to Mount Vernon, the Chrysler 200 extends well beyond its midsize shadow with character, comfort, and fuel efficiency. Receive huge cash discounts on the all-new remaining 200s at King City Chrysler in Mount Vernon. 38.9 seconds left to go in regulation. The Orphans with a one-point lead are the only point that has been scored here in the fourth quarter, and they're ahead 26-25.
Again, what will Mount Vernon do? Are they going to, they'll go for the steal, obviously, but how quickly will they foul down one with 38 seconds to go?
Shall be interesting to see. Hard to believe we near the end of this contest. It's just 26-25, Orphans on top. Length of the floor for the Orphans to go. They're going right to left.
Again, they are in their home white uniforms with red trim and red numerals. No trim on the numbers. The Rams are in their away black with orange trim. Orange numerics trimmed in white. Inbound it goes to Webster. Quickly tipped away. Payne will recover. Turnaround coming from Payne. No good. Rebound to Wood. And he's fouled. Chuck ball on the possession arrow favors the Orphans. Danny, what I'm mesmerized there is Clay Payne was poked in the eye on the way up. No call, so they're letting it go consistently down low.
You got to go up strong, and he's done that twice. And Mount Vernon right now still 0-7 from the field in the fourth quarter, have not made a field goal.
The trigger will go into Webster. Almost blocked again by the Rams. It'll be a lob up ahead. Bet from a two-on-one. Goes up, gets the shot, and it's good. Goes up off the right block, gets the points to make it 28-25. And goes to the line for the and one as he was fouled by Badger.
Two-on-one breakaway going the other way, and Badger, all he could do was go out and try to block the shot, and unfortunately Betts beat him to the rim, took the contact, and scored, put the Orphans up by three.
23.6 seconds to go, and the free throw's good. Centralia's up two possessions. And what could go wrong has gone wrong for the Rams here in the fourth quarter. It'll be picked up by Tribble. He kicked it and lost. It'll be Alcorn bringing it length to the floor. Layup is no good. Out of bounds off of Alcorn. No call to foul, but they're being consistent.
Yeah, what's the hurry? You're up by four. Pull that thing out. There is no hurry. Mount Vernon catches a break.
Trimble to bring it across the timeline. Far side. Looking to make something happen. Loses it. Gets it out to Flota. Once to three. Throws it up. No good. Rebound tipped away by Wood. And with 7 seconds to go, the Orphans will improve to 2-4. The Rams will fall here tonight. Dribbled out by Betts, and that is your final. The Centralia Orphans upset the Mount Vernon Rams, 29-25. We'll tell you all about it in the Bean and Trent postgame show coming up next.
Does this sound familiar?
I can't stand this job. I just wish I had time to go back to school, but with work and family...
I know. I just enrolled in Rend Lake College's evening cosmetology program. They have evening classes that will even fit into your busy schedule. You can even graduate in less than 2 years. Classes are convenient to get to, and they're in Studio RLC in Mount Vernon. They even offer financial aid.
What's it like? I've been out of school so long.
It's not your typical take notes. Listen to a lecture program. We will learn the latest styles and trends in cosmetology, and it looks like we'll have fun doing it. We'll be out on the salon floor getting hands-on experience and getting to know all kinds of people. By the time we're done, we'll be ready to jump into a new career and love our jobs for once.
Okay, how do I sign up?
I called 618-242-8459, but you can also check out their website at rlc.edu/studio-rlc or stop by the RLC Marketplace in Mount Vernon.
Hello, I'm Morgan. A few months ago, my gynecologist said that I needed surgery, a hysterectomy. I thought for sure I'd have to leave Southern Illinois to have it done, but I was surprised to find out that not only could Good Samaritan Regional Health Center do the surgery, they had one of the nation's most advanced surgical systems. They called it the Da Vinci. It was basically this robot that translated whatever movements the surgeon was making into even tinier, more precise movements. My doc even told me that over 100 of these procedures had been done at Good Samaritan. Well, the surgery went great, and I was out of the hospital in no time. And because I was close to home, my whole family was with me every step of the way. Good Samaritan is my new hospital of choice. And starting in 2013, they'll be opening an all-new regional health center with even more advanced services. It makes me happy to know they'll still be around when my kids have families and need specialized medical care. That means a lot to me.
Good Samaritan Regional Health Center. Raising a hospital, raising the bar.
Save some green with a free checking account from People's National Bank. A free checking account from People's National Bank comes with a free Visa check card, free online banking, free bill pay, and unlimited check writing. Save time, stamps, and the hassle with a free checking account from People's National Bank. Stop by either of our two locations in Mount Vernon today for details on how you can make your money bloom with a free checking account from People's National Bank.
People's National Bank, member FDIC, Visa check card, and bill pay non-usage fees may apply.
Hi, Roy Schmidt, Dodge dealer at King City Chrysler Mount Vernon. At King City, we want to be your caliber headquarters. Leave it to Dodge Caliber to modernize the driving experience. Similar vehicles offer an overdone sedan experience, while Caliber cranks it up with a bold five-door hatchback encounter. Oversized wraparound quad halogen headlamps, signature Dodge crosshair grille, and broad-shouldered wheel flares exude attitude with every turn. Dial up your personal driving experience with available chrome accents, fog lamps, and an aerodynamically designed rear spoiler. At King City Chrysler, we have a great selection of the 2011 Dodge Caliber ready for immediate delivery. Receive huge cash discounts or 1.9 for 72 months. We may even be able to lower your existing payment and you drive a new car. Come into King City Chrysler at 1603 Broadway in Mount Vernon, Illinois, and let's deal.
If I could change anything, you know what I'd change? I'd make it a law that if you tell someone to have a nice day, you really have to mean it. 100%.
Making your day better than it started out is what makes Erie Insurance above all in service. Auto, home, business, and life. Your Erie agent is waiting for you. And have a nice day.
Your Erie agent in Mount Vernon is the Bean Insurance Agency. Get a quote at beaninsurance.net.
This is Mount Vernon Rams basketball on WMIX, the Bean Insurance postgame show. Starts now.
And welcome back to the CHS Arena. The Centralia Orphans hang on to win this one 29-25. The Rams led by as many as eight. And then at the end of the third quarter, Stefanovic off of the right block, able to tie it up for the Orphans off of the right block again. And at that point, Centralia just never looked back. They had a 26-25 lead for most of the fourth quarter, only scoring the lone point. But then late, Metz was able to take advantage, got a shot to fall, I believe, from the right block, got to the end, one at the line, and made it a four-point ball game, and then the Orphans just never looked back. They're 2-4 on the year. The Rams fall to 4-2. Bean Insurance is an independent agency that can do the insurance shopping for you. Bean Insurance has multiple top insurance companies from which to choose with great rates for your family. Call Bean Insurance at 242-6017. That's 242-6017. Danny Zerwinski's alongside. I'm Chris Hugel. We'll have your scoring and stats come up in just a little bit, as that is calculated by Heartland Accounting. We'll also have a massive scoreboard update coming your way and remind you that for all of your financial services, see your local State Farm agent, Tony Wilt. Find him on the web at TonyWilt.com or walk in, call in, and click in like a good neighbor. State Farm is there. Of course, you see that red Jeep in the parking lot. Tony Wilt, of course, you know his office, 42nd Street, South Water Tower Place, there in Mount Vernon. We'll see if we get Scott Gamber up here tonight. I'm not certain if we will or not, but Danny, all in all, a hard-fought contest here tonight is exactly what we expected it to be. The Orphans always play the Rams well. Rams always play the Orphans well, regardless of who may be the better team coming into the game. And the Orphans just were able to win it tonight on their home floor with the emotions of raising that second-place banner in tow.
Well, perseverance. I mean, Centralia did not have a good first three quarters and then had the ability to come back in the fourth and clamp down defensively. Lee Bennett made an adjustment or two as far as the man-to-man defense goes. And he was able to bring up guys to trap across the timeline, force the turnover. He also went man-to-man to force the pace of the game a little bit, got Mount Vernon out of their offensive rhythm that they had for three quarters. And once that happened, Mount Vernon seemed to go away and become the less aggressive team. They were the more aggressive team through three quarters. The Rams weren't going to the rim with that strength that we had seen. And going to the rim, getting shots blocked, not going up strong, balls were bouncing off the rim. And unfortunately for Mount Vernon, you lead 25-23 at the end of three quarters, and you do not score a single point the entire fourth quarter, going 0 of 7 from the field, or 0 of 8, I should say. Tough way to lose when you had this game basically in your hands for about three-fourths of the game.
Of course, we have plenty of scoring and stats coming your way. I believe we have a scoreboard update ready for you or in the process of being ready for you.
Ready whenever you are.
Let's take it now.
Okay, scores and finals. JV game here tonight. Mount Vernon wins 33-27. Around the area in boys basketball, Benton beat Carroll tonight 69-47. Oakville beat Woodlawn 55-40. Marissa Coulterville beat New Athens 44-35. Sullivan over Windsor 51-37. Fairfield over Johnson City 67-54. ZR beat Weber Township 55-30. Marshall County, Kentucky over Harrisburg 72-58. Salem over Newton 64-62. One girls final, Marshall County, Kentucky defeated Mount Carmel girls 67-64. At the half, it's Cessna Valera over West Frankfort 32-19. Also, Pinckneyville, after three quarters, leading Waterloo-Jabot 25-24. At the half, it's DuCoin trailing Vandalia 26-17. at the Trico tournament tonight. It was Egyptian over Shawnee, 76-41, and Trico over Steelville, 48-30. Also an update, late fourth quarter, Marion leads Altoff by 10. That is late in the fourth quarter.
Of course, again, that's the Tony Wilt scoreboard update. We have your Heartland Accounting stats coming up here on your Bean Insurance postgame show. Chances are you're paying too much for auto insurance. Discount the wages of Bean Insurance Agency, but you won't know how much you can save until you give them a call. Bean Insurance, 242-6017. That's 242-6017. With Danny Zerwinski, I'm Chris Hugo. We'll take a break. Your final score, the Mountford and Rams falls to the Centralia Orphans here at the arena, 29-25. This is Rams Basketball on WMIX.
If you want a successful business, you need good partners. And if your need is printing, you won't find better partners than Mark and Carrie Smith.
Helping people is what we love.
But we need help with our financing.
That's why the Smiths and hundreds of local businesses trust Banterra. Banterra is the area's number one financial partner, offering commercial loans, treasury management, and remote deposit services. With Banterra as your partner, you can concentrate on what you do best. Banterra, banking with local style.
Equal housing lender, member FDIC.
America is a nation on wheels. Everyone has at least one automobile. We use them for shopping, work, everything we do. But they can be a threat. Some accidents can't be prevented. Your professional Pekin Insurance Agency, Page Insurance on Crownview and Mount Vernon, can help protect you from a large financial loss when an accident happens. Call Page Insurance today at 242-7000 about low-cost auto insurance from Pekin Insurance. Ask them about the many money-saving discounts that are available. Depend on your hometown professionals.
Insurance.
Rams letter jackets, all stars and stitches. Rams cheerleading jackets, all stars and stitches. Rams hoodies, all stars and stitches. Rams t-shirts, all stars and stitches. Rams car stickers, all stars and stitches. Rams yard signs, all stars and stitches. Rams apparel, all stars and stitches. Anything Mount Vernon Rams, all stars and stitches.
Okay, I get it. I can get anything Mount Vernon Rams at All Stars and Stitches. But where in the world is All Stars and Stitches?
All Stars and Stitches. We're located in Benton, half a block from the Benton High School. Our phone number is 618-435-5555. Give us a call.
Hey, are you thinking of starting your own business? Or maybe you already own your own business and have tax questions? Call Heartland Accounting today. At Heartland Accounting, we specialize in small business planning. Let us help you with your business bookkeeping, sales taxes, payroll taxes, or maybe just some solid business advice. Get started right, and let us help you make your business a success. Call Heartland Accounting of Mount Vernon today at 244-7077 or stop by 3000 Broadway, Suite 2B.
Back out to the 94 Sports Mobile Studios on WMIX and MyWithersRadio.com.
And welcome back to the Bean Insurance postgame show. Chris Hugo with Danny Zerwinski alongside. Mountford and Rams fall to 4-2 on the year as they fell to the Centralia Orphans 29-25. Chris Hugo, again, with Danny Zerwinski, who is working on your Heartland Accounting postgame stats. Actually, they've been done for quite a while. And it looks like we can get to the scoring right now.
The scoring right now in this one, the stats, I should say, is Mount Vernon was 8 of 18 from two-point range, 44%, 2 of 6 from the arc for 33%. The Rams go 10 of 24 for 42% in the ball game. At the end of three quarters, the Rams were 10 of 16. They finished 10 of 24 as they did not make a field goal in 8 attempts in the final frame. Centralia was 7 of 11 from two-point range, 64%, 4 of 14 from the arc for 29%. They go 11 of 25 from the field for 44%. Free throw shooting Mount Vernon, 3 of 6. Centralia, 3 of 7. Rebounding went to the Orphans, 17-15, as well as turnovers, Mount Vernon 15. Centralia had 10. Scoring, Mount Vernon had 16 points in the paint compared to Centralia's 10. Centralia had 4 bench points compared to Mount Vernon's 0. The scoring goes as followed. For the Orphans, they had 5 players scoring a game. Brian Betts led the way with 9. Jake Wood had 8. Chase Alcorn had 5. Lucas Stefanovich had 4. And Jalen Webster had 3. The Rams were led by Leonte Badger with 10 points. Trevor Flota with 7. Jaron Lydell with 6. And Clay Payne had 2 to give you a final score of Centralia 29, Mount Vernon 25.
Get started right and let Heartland Accounting help make your business a success. Heartland Accounting, 3000 Broadway, Suite 2B, your small business expert. 29-25, your final. Rams are 4-2 on the air. They're at St. Anthony tomorrow, and now, Danny, just kind of hope that you don't go into Effingham with a mega letdown.
Well, it's going to be tough because even with a win it was going to be hard. But now you're going into a situation, you're going on the road, you're playing a game that JV will tip off at 1 o'clock. And not much time to turn around. You still got to leave here, get on the bus, go home, get up, and then get back on the bus. And, you know, the varsity's probably going to be on the floor tomorrow about 2:30 warming up. So it's a very, very quick turnaround, and the Rams are going to have to put this one behind them very, very quickly.
Of course, very quickly indeed. And I'm not sure if we'll get to talk to Scott Gamber tonight here on the Bean Insurance postgame show, but we will get to talk to him tomorrow on the Saturday Sports Show. We'll also have a first-time guest on tomorrow morning. We're very excited about it. John Krause of the Oakville Rockets will join us tomorrow on the Saturday Sports Show. We'll announce some of our future guest list. I suppose you'll hear it on Facebook or read it on Facebook and Twitter tomorrow, as we have not booked all of our guests just yet. Wanted to see how things would play out tonight. And what an exciting one, I know, going on at Oakville in the championship game there. But we did we get a final? I think you said something.
Yes, Vermont lost to Oakville 55-40.
That's really not bad. That was supposed to be a hot game going in, and a hot one it was indeed. And I don't think we're going to get Scott Gibber tonight. That's fine. We'll talk to you tomorrow. We'll take a break, come back. You're the first bank player of the game. This is Rams Basketball on WMIX.
It's amazing how versatile the Saturday Sports Show has become. What do you mean you slept in last week? Set your alarm for 8:08 this Saturday morning and tune your radio to AM 940. More Mount Vernon Rams talk, more Jefferson County talk, and more amped up coverage of Southern Illinois sports. Hear from the best coaches, experts, and sports know-it-alls available. Sports talk worth waking up for. Saturday mornings from 8:08 till 10 a.m. on WMIX AM 940 and online at mywithersradio.com. Presented by Crossroads Community Hospital.
Hi, Joe David Cummins with Community First Bank. With five locations in Jefferson County, a seven-month .77% APY CD special, free checking, free internet banking, and free debit cards tied to local schools, isn't now the perfect time to move your banking relationship to a local community bank? No gimmicks, just your neighbors and friends taking care of your banking needs.
Community First Bank with locations in Mount Vernon, Woodlawn, Dix, and Ina. Welcome back to Personal Banking. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
This is Mount Vernon Rams Basketball on WMIX. Time for the Community First Bank of the Heartland Player of the Game.
And welcome back to the CHS Arena. The Rams fall here tonight, 29-25 to the Orphans. The Orphans are now 2-4 on the year. The Rams just, I say just, really still a good record, 4-2. But a surprise, I think, here tonight if you're a Rams fan. Thinking that this might be the Rams year to get a pretty convincing win at the arena. But on an emotional night for the Orphans, they just had troubles in that fourth quarter.
I just couldn't score. And I think the defensive pressure and the switches that Centralia threw at Mount Vernon, it caused him to disrupt the flow. Mount Vernon wasn't as aggressive as they were in three quarters. And turnover here, turnover there. When you're playing in a game with a 29-25 total score, every possession counts. Every possession is so very important. And Mount Vernon did not take care of that orange tonight, especially in that fourth quarter.
They did not. It's time now for your Community First Bank of the Heartland Player of the Game. We didn't really confer on the break, but as we remember the stats from a moment ago, I think there's a couple guys that stick out, but one all the way.
Well, Batcher had 10 points and 5 rebounds. Jaron Lydell had a good game, 6 points, and a board did a good job defensively as well, so we got a couple of choices.
I thought Lydell was kind of the difference in the game.
I did
for
too.
The Rams. He was that spark that kind of got things going, played well down low, and so Jaron Lydell is your Community First Bank Player of the Game. Great traditions aren't given, they are earned through hard work and commitment. That's just what they believe in. Community First Bank of the Heartland, proud sponsors of the Rams. A great tradition. That is going to do it for us tonight. Don't forget the Saturday Sports Show tomorrow, 8:08 until 10 o'clock, AM 940, online at mywithersradio.com. Look for our guest list on Facebook, like us, WMIX Sports, or you can follow us on Twitter, at 94 Sports, where you will find a comprehensive scoreboard, on Twitter and on Facebook. Sometime later tonight or early tomorrow. Your final here, the Mount Vernon Rams 29. Excuse me, the Centralia Orphans 29, the Mount Vernon Rams 25. For Danny Zerwinski, for Jeff Crow, for Jesse Clark, for everyone at Withers Broadcasting, thank you for listening to Rams Basketball. We're back on the road tomorrow against St. Anthony. We'll have video for you on mywithersradio.com, live coverage on 94.1 FM. I'm Chris Hugo. Good night from Centralia.
Thank you for listening to Mount Vernon Rams Basketball on WMIX and watching worldwide on MyWithersRadio.com. Rams Basketball is powered by the official voice of the Mount Vernon Rams, Pantera Bank. Banking with local style. The Mount Vernon Rams on WMIX are also sponsored by Ford Square and King City Chrysler. You can count on us, Community First Bank of the Heartland. Welcome back to Personal Banking. State Farm Insurance Agent Tony Wilt. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Second Chance Auto. Good Samaritan Regional Health Center. raising a hospital, raising the bar. Schmidt Chevrolet of Mount Vernon, Wren Lake College. Visit your virtual counselor at rlc.edu. And also by the Orthopedic Center of Southern Illinois, Heartland Accounting, All Stars and Stitches, Bean Insurance, Central Christian Church, and People's National Bank. For inside information before, during, and after the game, follow us on Twitter at 94 Sports or like WMIX Sports on Facebook. Your home for news, sports, and today's hot country. We are the legendary WMIX.